I love our money. So they come out, they have hands on them, they shake, I love you, sir, I love you, sir. But we gave them back their jobs. They were dead. And you know, Hillary came in just before West Virginia, says, no, we want the miners, we're going to retrain them, and they'll be doing. Can you imagine a miner with, you know, massive arms, shoulders, they love what they're doing, sticking in a line, little tiny widgets. They're putting little tiny computer parts together, this big strong, and they don't want to be doing that. And I said to them, it's the only time they ever got angry at me, I said to them, fellas, supposing, is there any truth? Supposing we take you out of that business and we do retrain you and you go into technology, okay? They almost threw up all over the place. And it's a funny thing, you know, to me I call it dangerous and rough stuff, but it's become much safer. In Australia now they have no black lung disease, they've really got all of that dust out of there, they've done a fantastic job, we're copying that system, we give credit where credit is due. But it's incredible. But, you know, they were talking about retraining these guys. By the way, I was thinking about it too. I'd walk in and I look at these big rough guys. I said, no, they don't want to do that. And I said, well, would you want that? Would you want any retraining? And the one guy looks at me and says, sir, my great grandfather was a miner. My grandfather, my father, and I'm a miner. And we love our life. We want to dig coal. That's what we want to do, sir. We don't want anything else. We want to just dig coal. It's true. You couldn't, if I said, I'm going to give you an apartment on Fifth Avenue, you come with me, you're going to have a great time in New York, they would say, no, thank you. It's just the way it is, you know. That's their life. That's what they want. They love it. They don't want to do anything different, and I understand it. I'm the only fool that decided to do something. I had a great life. And then I said, let's run for president and straighten this country out. And we've been hit harder than anybody in history. One thing I've taught people, though, no rich guys ever run for politics.